Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. We have already covered BLE in many Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos. We have even covered an overview of BLE Mesh, its features and applications in one of those videos. Please check that out from the link in the description before proceeding with this video. In this video, we will learn about the different layers in the BLE Mesh stack. Bluetooth Mesh builds on top of Bluetooth Low Energy. It specifically utilizes the advertising state of BLE devices. Devices within a Bluetooth Mesh network do not connect to each other like traditional BLE devices do. Rather, they use the advertising and scanning states to relay messages to each other. This is the BLE Mesh architecture. Let's discuss each layer starting from the bottom one by one. 1. Bluetooth Low Energy Layer. As we mentioned before, Bluetooth Mesh builds on top of BLE. So it requires a full BLE stack to be running on the device. It utilizes the advertising and scanning states for sending and receiving messages between devices within the mesh network. It also supports the connected state and GAT for special devices called proxy nodes. 2. Bearer Layer. The bearer layer defines how the different mesh packets are handled. There are two types of bearers in BLE Mesh. A. Advertising Bearer. This bearer utilizes the advertising and scanning states of the BLE devices. B. GAT Bearer. This bearer utilizes the connection state of BLE devices. It allows non-mesh supporting devices to interact with the mesh network via GAT operations. This is accomplished via a special node called the proxy node. 3. Network Layer. This layer defines how transport layer messages are addressed towards one or more elements. 4. Lower Transport Layer and Upper Transport Layer. Lower Transport Layer handles two main tasks: segmentation of packets from the layer above and reassembly of packets from the layer below. Upper Transport Layer is responsible for the following functionalities: encryption, decryption, authentication, transport control messages. 5. Access Layer. This layer defines how the application uses the Upper Transport Layer. It handles the following tasks: application data format, encryption and decryption, data verification. 6. Foundation Models and Models Layer. Foundation layer is concerned with the network configuration and network management models. Models layer addresses the implementation of models including behaviors, messages, states, and state bindings. There are three types of models: server model, client model, and control model. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.